A long time ago, I was asked, what's the difference between Gork and Mork? And I told the lad, Gork is brutal and cunning, and Mork is cunning and brutal. And the silly kid said it sounded the same. You know what I told him? I said the difference lies is that all the Morksiest oryxes are still around, and all the Gorksiest oryxes are at the bottom of the swamp, just where he was about to be. Welcome to the Everdank, a beautiful, damp, and fungi-covered paradise. We have plenty of things you'll like down here. There are lots of creepy crawlers. Oh, there goes a big one now. There's fungi on every corner of your body, that is. Oh, and there are big, cuddly trolls. We have squigs. Don't worry, they don't bite. Unless they're alive, of course, and then they bite a lot. Hey, I was going to eat that. We even have a Ragnarok for you to worship. Hi there, Shelob. Yes, all hail the spider god. Well, anyway, what do you think? Do you like it down here? Did I mention it doesn't matter because you can never leave?
What's up, everyone? Welcome to another battle report for Sag of Dice. We got Alex back again. Some of you may not remember Alex. It's been a while.
It has been.
What did you play last? Was it Giants?
Maybe.
Maybe.
I have no idea.
He'll give you a definite maybe. You are bringing more destruction. Yes. Now, this is unusual for you because you don't normally play destruction, correct?
No, I'm usually playing lots of order armies like Fire Slayers that one time.
Yeah. And oh, that's true. You did play Fire Slayers.
See?
Yeah.
I play lots of order.
Yeah.
Like Iron Jaws.
This will only fool people that don't know you very well.
Yeah.
Big destruction fan, so you brought the Cruel Boys.
Yep.
Which is nice, because that means I don't have to play Cruel Boys. I like Cruel Boys a lot, but they're not the easiest army to deal with right now in terms of playing with them. Playing against them is less so.
Playing against them is a joy.
Actually, you played Ogres last time you were on the channel.
Yes, I did.
And I played Cruel Boys.
Yes. before Ogres got nerfed.
Yes, that's true.
I brought
day one.
Super cheap day one Iron Blasters.
All four.
To have a rather nice friendly time with your non-Grinning Blades Cruel Boys.
Yep. Before they got buffed too. Yeah.
That went about as well as people could expect.
Indeed, yeah. If you want to watch someone be sad, you can go watch that. I'm just kidding. It was actually a fun battle report. But today I brought goblins. It's been a little while since I brought my cult of the Once in a Blue Moon. So we'll be back in a bit with the army list. But first, if you want to support the channel, we've got a Patreon. There's a bunch of videos on there. Some of our best material is actually on there, unfortunately. But you can do that. And if not, it's totally cool. That's why we do these free battle reports. But if you could like and subscribe and do all those things, it would help other people find the channel. I'm not sure what your point. Oh, you're pointing down the subscribe button. That's true.
Yeah.
I didn't see it there. It's behind the table, in my defense. So anyway, we're playing Path of the Champion, by the way.
Yeah, we're playing Path of the Champion.
I should probably mention that. But we'll be back in a moment with the army lists. Today we are playing Path of a Champion. The zones are the quarter, like the corners. And if you have a Galatian champion on an objective wholly outside your territory, you can pick two battle tactics to do. And other than that, it's all the same. One, two more, 2 points for your battle tactics, and that's pretty much it. We'll be back with the lists in just a moment.
Okay, this is my Cruel Boys army. It's in Grinning Blades, which is probably no surprise to anyone.
Mm-hmm.
It's the good one right now.
Yep. The only good one right now.
The only good one right now.
Yeah.
It basically means that outside of 12 inches, I cannot be seen.
Right.
And then my grand strategy is war, which is essentially, I believe it's take what's theirs, but better.
Okay.
Because I only need to have one battle line or my general in the enemy territory.
Oh, okay.
Although, is it better? Maybe. I don't know. Because my battle line in this case is these, and those.
Right.
So maybe it is, maybe it isn't. Whereas take what's there is anyone.
That's true.
So in the list, we have a killer boss with stab grot, and he's got the scare shield to give him a free up save.
Nice.
He's in the list because he's cool.
That's true.
And then we've got a Merknob with Belcher Banner. He's in the list because, honestly, I could not stomach the idea of having a third squad of Hobgrots. And he's going to have the aspect of the champion Tunnel Master.
So okay.
Once per game, he can teleport.
Heck yeah.
And then we're going to have two Swamp Caller Shamans because they are mandatory in Cruel Boys.
That's true.
So this guy is going to have the artifact Mork's Eye Pebble,
yep.
Which is the one which in the shooting phase, so not really relevant in this game.
No, right.
Holy Within 12 gives me a 5-up ward.
Actually, that's not true.
Once per game.
Well, that's less good. Cruel Boys artifacts are the worst.
And his spell is going to be Choking Mist.
Cool.
Which has a 24-inch range, 6-inch AoE when it hits, and it cancels all runs and gives you -1 to your attack's characteristic until my next hero phase.
Nice.
This guy has Nasty Hex, which turns off ward saves.
Sure does.
And then my general is the Snatcher boss on Sludraker Beast. He has Super Sneaky, which means that before the turn priority is decided, after we've deployed, I get to pick up a unit and redeploy it anywhere on the table outside 9.
Very cool.
He's got the Artifact of Power, Eye Biter Ash.
Nice.
Which is random, whether it does nothing.
Anything at all.
-1 to hit right then, or -1 to hit for the rest of the game.
Yep. Or nothing at all.
Nothing at all. And he has the mount trait Smellian, which means that if he didn't charge, he's -1 to be hit.
That's pretty cool.
For battle line, we've got two squads of Hobgrot Slitters. And then we've got a squad of 10 Gut Rippers and a squad of 20 Gut Rippers.
Nice.
I am still holding in my heart that reinforced squads of Gut Rippers are good, and I will not give that up. However, one thing I have given up on is not bringing crossbows.
Yes.
So we've brought 6 crossbows,
yeah.
6 more crossbows,
yeah.
And 6 more crossbows.
18 crossbows.
So there's a lot of crossbows here.
You are gross.
And
so
for core battalions, we have Galatian sharpshooters for all our crossbows, of
Checks
course. And then we've got a Warlord battalion and a Cruel Boys finger battalion.
Nice.
So the Warlord battalion is what's giving me the extra artifact. And once per game, I'll be able to claim another CP.
Cool.
And the Cruel Boys finger, once per game, I can claim another CP. So I have access to 2 extra CP during the game if I want.
That's pretty good.
And it's 2,000 points on the dot.
Nice. We'll be back in just a moment with the Goblins list. Today, I have brought 1990 points of Gloomspy Gits. And leading this faction, and I brought Glog's Mega Mob, and leading said mob of kindly young trolls is this guy here. He has the Alpha Trog, which gives him the monster keyword and 2 wounds, the Glowy Howitz, of course, for the 4-up ward, and he's just a boss, and he looks cool too, like a centipede. And then we've got this guy here. He's also in my Warlord Battalion. He has the Moonface Moppet. And then we've got 2 units of 6 trolls, the Gobapalooza, Scragrot, a unit of Sneaky Snufflers, 30 Squigs with 6 handlers for a total of 36 fellers. And for the first time ever on the channel, a Squig boss, which I hurriedly painted last night at midnight. It looks like the paint is dry now on his base, which I just finished before Alex showed up. He has Tunnel Master, and that's it. That's everything. So that's 1990 points. I think I'm 5 drops. Oh, and I've got the Ravnix. I almost forgot. It's 1990 points. I am 5 drops. So I will be getting to choose who goes first when we get set up here. And yeah, we'll be back in a moment with whoever's going first.
Okay, so this is what it looks like after deployment. So Rob was going to have priority on the turn. Before he chooses who goes, I do super sneaky, so I picked up a squad of Bolt Boys and I put them back there because they fit back there, and I thought it'd be very cheeky because they're still outside of 12, so they're not visible.
That's true.
But they are close enough so that they can then move so that they can see past the trees and then use their rapid fire shots on some of the tasty targets in the back.
Mm-hmm.
And knowing that, Rob took the turn.
It's true.
Which means I then do my dirty tricks.
Yeah.
And Crow Boys now get to do two dirty tricks instead of one.
Mm-hmm.
So the one you're always going to pick is going to be minus one to wound in the first battle round.
Right.
And then the second one I'm doing in this case is going to be the lethal surprise. So I roll three dice, four ups, I get to choose one. So I'm going to get to choose one piece of terrain or objective that's wholly outside, not wholly within Rob's territory.
Yep.
Another two up. When he gets there the first time within an inch, he's going to take d6 mortal wounds. So I'm going to choose one now.
Cool.
Okay.
Okay. And I choose where the moon goes as well before the turn starts, and I'm going to choose for it to go in this corner here.
Okay.
So we'll be back with my turn in just a moment. Welcome to Gloomspite Gits Turn 1. Very excited to get them on the table again. For my battle tactic, I've chosen gaining momentum. And for my heroic action, I am going to try and gain a CP on my general right there. So I need to roll a four up. I did not do it, but I also get to roll a dice for the Fungoid Cave Shaman on a four up. I just get a CP. Nope. Cool.
Keep going, Rob.
Great story.
Keep rolling dice.
Yeah, yeah. I'm going to pick different dice for my spell casting phase. Oh, by the way, we're not using the dice tray today because I've had an issue with my editing software and I can't make it work for now, but I'm going to keep trying to figure it out and it'll hopefully be back soon. So, first up,
gaining momentum, Rob chose this unit back.
Oh, I did choose that unit. Yeah, that's right. I forgot. I said it off camera.
The cheeky unit at the back.
Yep.
Used to be murdered.
Very cheeky. Those idiots.
I'm so heartbroken.
I know.
For my heroic action, I'm going to take another Unbind because I have two wizards in range of his wizards right now, and I might as well have a third attempt at an Unbind from one of my random heroes here. So
this is all true. Yeah.
I just have three Unbind attempts.
Yep. So up first is going to be these guys here. They're going to try and do Fungoid Cloud.
Okay.
I believe I need a six for this. So that is not a six. That is just one below what I needed. And then I'm going to try and do Squig Lure to make it so my squigs can reroll their charge, because otherwise they can't, because they don't get any commands. Well, that's cool. At least I did that the
this
second.
This is going well.
This is going really well. So one mortal wound on them. That's just fantastic. I will mark that down right now with one mortal wound and the guy in the corner. And then, I'm going to use different dice again.
Are the Squighead casting that spell, or is it the wizard?
Oh, duh. Yeah, you're totally right. Oh, and then they have a four-up ward in the battle round one. No.
No.
They just take it.
Rob is rolling like trash.
Yeah, yeah. So I'm rolling like normal, essentially. Yeah, yeah. Cool. Okay. More good news. So then, who's next? I guess it's going to be this guy here. Do you like how you haven't even needed to attempt to unbind anything so far? Oh, dear. Here we go. So I think it's a seven. I got it at an eight.
To cast.
Yeah.
What are you casting?
Oh, the Hand of Gork.
Okay. I will attempt to unbind it with one of my unbinds.
You might as well. I've only got three casts left.
I got an eight as well, which does not do it because I'm not plus one to unbind.
So then this guy.
You get to teleport.
I get to teleport. I'm going to teleport over back here.
How dare you?
I know, right?
And he's going to teleport within 12 so that I'm actually visible.
Yeah, exactly.
Because the problem Rob was having was I wasn't even visible outside of 12, which meant he couldn't even target me with spells.
This is exactly correct. Actually, I'm going to do it on over here so I keep my general in the light of the bad moon, because that is my grand strategy. I got to keep him in the light of the bad moon for at least three turns. Or battle rounds? I think it's battle rounds.
I don't know.
It doesn't matter. I gotta make sure it happens, right? So so then we go, so he is now in there. And I don't. You might have to remeasure it to see.
I will have to remeasure to yeah. see if I can unbound.
Here, so wait. Who was the one who unbound the last one?
The guy who.
Okay. So.
So can this guy unbound?
Yes. Yeah, he can.
Yeah. Okay. I still have an unbind.
Is he? What about? Oh, then this guy's out now.
That guy's
yeah,
out.
Yeah. Okay. So you can unbind one of these.
I have one unbind.
So he's gonna try and do his war scroll spell.
Oh, the one which goes off automatically unless you roll two ones.
Exactly.
Nice.
I did not roll two ones. But that is and it's plus one because it's Grandma. Yeah.
I will try to unbind it.
Do it.
I rolled a 7.
You did.
So it's gone. No spell for you.
Bye bye. But now.
Cruel boys win.
Now I get Ravenix.
Stop it.
Yes.
I forgot he had Ravenix.
Yeah. Yay. I wish I rolled that earlier. That's a 10.
That's a 10. So oh no. Here it comes.
So I'm going to do this for fun right now. So it's actually just has to be with an 8, huh?
Yeah. You basically put it on my face.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh no.
Okay. And I'll roll it at
the
end.
Boys were too sneaky.
I mean, we're pretty good at it too, you know. So then I'm going to put an extra pip of rend on this guy here. From these guys.
Spider.
Nasty poisons. And then this guy here, my Squig Herder, is going to give the 6 plus to hit, makes these guys do mortal wounds, the Squig Herd here.
Okay.
And then I'm going to roll Ravenix, and then at the start of my turn, I'm going to give my Squigs a 5-up ward from these guys. I'll roll everything right now, though.
Okay.
So these guys do it because they're in the light of the bad moon. They give them a ward on a 2-up, and on a 5-up, they get an extra attack.
Okay.
Oh, barely get the ward.
Okay.
Good thing they're in the light of the bad moon. And then I got to remember to put down, I'm just putting down Flaming Weapon next to them just so I have something to remind me. And now we roll this guy.
No.
3d6.
And because it's just been summoned, it can be rerolled.
Oh, right. Good call. I will reroll that. Because 5, 8, 9, that's a little worse than average. I want big money, Alex.
You want big money?
Yeah.
Oh,
that's worse.
It's worse.
But only by
7.
Yeah.
So
whatever.
So he's going to do 2 mortal wounds.
Yes, on a 2-up.
On a 2-up, so you need to roll your 2-up,
zoop,
sir.
Yep, which I don't know about now.
Roll your 2-up. Oh.
Yay!
Ah.
So it did how many, just 2?
2.
Yeah, fair enough.
So I'm just gonna kill this guy.
Cool. What an abysmal turn, Alex.
That's what you get for taking first turn, right?
That's true, I always regret it. Actually, that's not true. I usually do better. Cool. That's the end of my hero phase. Oh, you haven't done your. Did you do? Oh, you did your heroic action. It's a plus one bind. Yep. Got it. Okay. But yeah, we'll be back at the end of the movement phase in just a moment.
Okay.
So we're at the end of the movement phase, and we moved into the shooting phase, and now we are into the charge phase. But just to do a quick recap, these guys moved over here. They did not get a great roll, but and then he teleported with his once per game tunnel master. These guys ran 6. And these guys moved up. They're gonna attempt a 9-inch charge, but not super likely. yeah.
We bumped that guy. We'll push him back into coherency for all our coherency hawks out there.
Right. Oh, and just to explain things, like for the 25 millimeter bases, they're in coherency as long as they're in base to base.
Yep.
Because an inch is 25.4 millimeters and coherency is 1 inch. So yep. If they're on base to base, they're easily within.
Okay.
Anyway, so.
So charge phase.
Charge phase.
Roll first?
Definitely this guy.
This guy's gonna roll first.
He kind of needs to.
He's
make
looking
it.
To make it into these guys.
Yeah.
Will he make
so,
a 7-inch charge?
Need a 7. And he gets
a 6.
I'm going to reroll it.
Spend the CP to reroll it.
Yep.
Oh, can he make a 7-inch charge?
God
dang
it.
Oh, it's even worse.
Okay.
Oh.
Man.
Does Scraggy get a long bomb charge? Is he feeling lucky?
What's his attack profile? Like, actually,
we're getting desperate, guys.
He can't take out. No, I think
we're getting desperate, guys.
No, he can't. Scrag, he literally can't kill them. He literally can't kill them on his
I mean, I'm only bravery 5.
No, I know, but.
Do we send
him in? Oh, I see what you're saying.
Do we send
him in? No, I have to kill them all.
Do we send him in?
No, for the last time.
You should charge him.
No, I shouldn't.
I just want to unleash Hell Scraggrot.
You know what sucks is that I accidentally bumped this guy in between, and I think he was a 6-inch charge before, but anyway. So,
so you have 2 units left to charge.
These guys are charging next. I needed 4 for them.
Ooh,
they finally make it.
That's the big charge.
So I will.
The charge? He didn't.
I guess
need.
I have to. Yeah, exactly. Yay. Yeah, I guess I'll move them in and we'll be.
You can roll these first if you want.
Oh, right.
Just to make it easier.
So it's 11 for these guys and I need a 9 or more. That's not a 9.
That's not a 9.
So, and I can't reroll again.
So just these guys making the charge.
Yay.
So we'll be back after an entire cluster has moved forward.
Okay, this is what it looks like after Rob's made his charge with this glorious conga line.
Indeed, yeah. And again, they are in base-to-base because they are they're in coherency rather because they're all in base-to-base contact. So.
Interestingly, because he's not within 3 inches, when these guys unleash hell, they're going to be doing the aimed shot as opposed to the hasty shot.
Yeah.
So I'm going to get 6 less shots, so I was debating even doing it.
Right.
I am actually going to do it, though, because I figured I'm going to be forced to melee him anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm gonna force it. I'm gonna have a battle shot capping in my face anyway, so I might as well just shoot him.
So on freeze. There were no 6s there, so no mortal wounds for me.
Wow! Right, and because you didn't get a hero phase yet, you couldn't put the poison on them either.
And then freeze to wound. So it is gonna be 5 at rend 1 and damage 2 each.
So they all go through, because they're a 6-up save.
Okay, so it's 10 damage.
10 damage,
for you to
okay.
do a 5-up ward.
Excellent. Are we going to have, like, dueling bad rolling
yes,
the whole game?
That's the plan.
Excellent. So 5-up ward.
Ooh, that's a good roll, though.
Whoa. I spoke way too soon. I saved almost all of them? What the crap?
Although check his dice.
Yeah. I mean, do we really want to complain about my dice? Yeah.
That's not 2.
I mean,
that's 1.5. They're 2 wounds each. And I only did 3 damage.
Yeah, you did 3 wounds, but it's 2 guys are dead because you did I did 1 wound. Oh, no, that's right. It was on these guys.
Yeah.
I forgot. So, I'm trying to kill more than I should.
He's trying to kill too many because he wants to do a big battle.
He knows me too well. That was Unleash Hell. I guess I'll pile them in.
Yeah.
And we'll be right back with some squig action.
Goodbye, cruel world.
The squigs have made their glorious charge. They have been unleashed hell upon, and Alex used his nasty trick, and he did some kind of weird chaos dwarfy kind of explosion that happened.
Yep,
and
it was my lethal surprise.
Lethal surprise. He rolled 5. He did 5. You rolled a 5, and then you rolled 5 again.
5,
yeah, so you got 5 mortal wounds total.
So that's why I've got a few more dead squigs.
Yep, 4 total dead little piggy mushroom guys. So now I'm going to attack with my squigs. I'm going to do the first round first.
Okay.
I'm hitting on 4s, wounding on 4s because you're -1 to wound in the first battle round. And what else? Oh, 6s to hit do mortal wounds in addition.
Yep.
And I'm an extra pip of rend from Gobbapalooza.
Okay.
So
I'm still making him roll this, guys.
Yes. No, that checks
been
out.
He's rolling so poorly.
Yeah, exactly. So we've got 5 mortal wounds so far.
Okay.
And then it's 4s to hit, as said earlier.
There's a 3 there.
There's a 3 there as well. Oh, I know. Yeah.
Building 3.
Oh yeah, and these are in addition.
Okay, so 5 mortals.
So 5 mortals.
And then
just gonna make sure
roll some 4-ups.
Okay.
5 4-ups and you kill the unit. There's more than 5 4-ups.
There's more than 6s.
Oh.
I got 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 7 6s there.
So that's a dead unit of Hobgrots who
huzzah!
Adequately screened for our Gut Rippers. So we'll be back with the Gut Rippers striking back.
Okay, so this is what it looks like after the gut rippers have piled in. I'm actually going to spend one of my 2 CP I have left to do all-out attack.
Nice.
Seven bite as well.
Yep.
So this is going to be hitting on freeze, and sixes are going to be 2 mortal wounds each because we're within the range of the snatcher boss.
Cool.
Okay.
That's so a good amount of sixes.
Nice amount of sixes. Oh, baby.
So 10 mortals so far. So
10 mortal wounds so far. Oh, yeah.
And they're hitting on
freeze. And we're hitting on freeze because I gave myself all that attack, which seems to have paid off for now.
Yeah, a lot of threes in there.
Yeah, and 4s to wound. And so that's going to be 5 at no rend.
5 at no rend is sixes. No sixes.
No sixes, so that's going to be 15 damage.
Oh, 15, shoot. Okay.
Oh,
so we got
15 5-up ward saves.
15 fives, huh? 5, you say. What did Squigs ever do to hurt anyone? I know. I was there. Pepperidge Farms remembers. 5's up. Okay, oh. So we saved... Only 3. Good lord.
Okay,
1, 12. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 dead squigs.
Oh.
Yikers. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oops. I just knocked over your guy. He counts as dead, you know.
He counts as dead now.
Yeah. No. That house rules. Oh my
okay.
God.
Okay. Do you want to go ahead and just roll your battle shock now?
I don't know. So. Actually, I guess I could just zap.
Or you could either the roll bejeebers. Your Battleshock, or you could use your Battleshock Triumph, which I assume you've taken.
Well, I can, but do I just want to zap, like, your Shaman, for example, who's within 9?
That is the question.
Or these guys, for example, who are also within range? This looks bad for the Cape Crusader. Okay, so let's do the math here. So I've got... 5, 10 dead piggies, right?
Yep.
10 dead piggies is bravery 3. So that's 7 plus a dice roll.
Yep.
But I could just zap him. 7 plus...
You could potentially just blow my Shaman up. But then the problem is, I'm going to have a turn where yep. I get to attack you. So I'm going to whittle that unit down.
That's true. But then I get to mortally wound you again, maybe.
You maybe do, yeah.
Yeah.
We're here to give the tough choices.
But then if I zap him off the board, which is extremely likely,
yes.
by the way.
Then
you just don't get to apply poison to them either. And you're down to a Galatian champion.
Yep.
I'm gonna do it.
Okay.
I'm gonna do
roll the battle shot.
Okay, here we go.
Let's see the battle shot.
Do. Let me know in the comments if this was a terrible decision.
Well, I guess we'll find out when he rolls a 6.
Yeah! 4.
It's a 4.
So 11.
Yeah, so 11
guys. And I get to do these one at a time.
You do get to do these one at a time. You definitely have 11 guys who are within 9
yeah,
inches
yeah.
of him.
So he has 6 wounds, correct?
He has, I think it's 6 wounds.
So
yes, he has 6 wounds. So do you just want to roll 6 2-ups?
That's what I was thinking. And then, yeah, exactly. So I'll do that first.
Okay, let's see the first 6 disappear.
Oh,
and he blows up.
Yeah, he's
goodbye.
Gone. Yeah.
No.
And then okay. I've got how many left? 5?
Yeah, 5.
So I've got
11.
I might as well put it into the...
Who are you going to put it into?
These guys.
Okay.
That makes sense, right?
Up to you.
I think that checks out. I could theoretically eliminate this guy as well.
That guy?
Yeah.
No, he's too tough for that. He's got 6 wounds.
Oh!
And he has a guy he can put in the way, even of mortal wounds.
Okay.
Because why not?
Okay, so I'll put it into the crossbow guys because
okay.
I may be able to battle shock them a bit or something too, so.
I may go lose up to 1 guy on battle shock because they're within 3 of this guy.
Oh, cool, okay. Well.
But you can still kill them.
I can still do something,
oh,
so.
Oh, not with a roll like that.
Two dead.
Okay, we're gonna lose 2. Oops.
I mean, I could only have gotten 1 more wound on them.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah. Okay,
and then, and then if one runs, and then it's still just losing 1 extra wound.
Yeah.
So
battle shocks from me then.
Yeah.
So let's do the battle shock on these guys.
Cool.
I rolled a 2 plus 2 is 4 versus bravery 5, so I don't lose anyone else.
Nice. Well done.
And these guys in the back.
Yeah.
So the question for Rob.
Yes.
Is, can I lose 5 guys?
Yeah. When I've lost one and have 5 bravery.
I'm not sure what you mean.
I need to roll 2d6 to make that even possible. So I rolled a 6, so I have to lose one extra guy.
That's crazy. Ah. I mean, to be fair, they're staring down the mouth of this giant flaming spell, which
it's also my fault for being a jerk about it. So that's going to be the end of the turn.
Yes.
Rob is going to hold one objective.
Yep.
He's going to hold 2 objectives, which also means he holds more. He's actually holding 3 objectives.
Yeah.
However, he has failed his battle tactic.
Of course.
Because he could not rely on a 7-inch rerollable charge.
No. Nope.
Which is why our friend Eric likes to say annihilators are bad.
That's true.
Okay, so we'll meet you back here for Crow Boys 10-1. Okay, so here we are, Crow Boys. I'm going to gain a CP because it's now my turn.
Cool.
I'm going to roll for another CP on my general.
Nice.
So on a 4 up. Oh, failed it.
So close, yet so far away. I'm going to try and roll for a CP on Scragrot. No, I'm going to roll it on my general because he's cool. And I like him. 4 up. Nope. Sure didn't.
Okay. The battle tactic I'm going
to be consistent.
Going to do is going to be the Cruel Boys one, where I do 10 or more wounds or mortal wounds.
Yeah.
And I take 10 or less
wounds.
Wounds or mortal wounds.
Right on.
And the other thing I'm going to do is I'm actually going to spend a CP to rally.
Nice.
I'm going to try rally these guys.
Okay.
6 up. Nope. That was worth it. I will also take my Crow Boy's finger, the CP now, to go back to 2.
Nice. Heck yeah.
So spells. Okay. I have 1 cast. Because my other shaman just exploded randomly, apparently.
Yep.
And he's going to attempt to cast Choking Mist.
Cool.
Which fails. and then
Sweet.
Because of that battle scroll update, he can cast a spell and use his poisons.
Yep.
So he's going to put his poison on these guys.
Smart.
So then we'll come back after movement phase.
So before we go into what Alex did in the movement phase, I did roll Ravenic's Gnashing Jaws.
Yep.
And
they're missing.
Where did they go, Alex?
They died. It was horrible.
They got eaten by Ravenic.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Rob rolled hot.
I did.
And on a 2-up, he was going to kill the entire squad. And he rolled a 2-up.
I rolled a 6, yeah.
So my cheeky ploy has gone horribly.
You're too cheeky for your own good, as usual, Alex. But why don't you walk us through your movement phase here?
Okay, so I've just generally, like, most of the army shifted this way.
Yeah, pretty
and
much.
And then these guys moved out in front for better screening.
Yep.
And then these guys have just moved because they're going to eventually go over there anyway.
Cool.
The cool thing here, though, is that I was just within range, so I'm going to be able to get hasty shots from them onto them.
Nice.
And then these guys will also be hasty shotting into them. So this is hopefully going to be really painful for those squigs.
Yes.
We might as well start the shooting phase.
Okay.
So I'm going to spend a CP to give myself +1 to hit.
Nice.
And I'm going with these guys first.
That makes sense. You're going to put the +1 to hit on the unit that's more full?
I mean, we should probably put it on the guy with the banner, really.
Right? Yeah.
You know, this guy who's not even shooting.
Yeah, yeah.
We're going to put it on the Hasty Shot.
He is pretty cool.
He is.
Yeah.
So because they moved.
I love the Belchaban, though. Can I just say that real quick?
It is cool.
The Belchaban is dope.
It's not great, but it's
not great, no. Yeah. It's not even a 4-up. It's a 5-up, whether he does anything.
Yeah. Okay, so these guys, because they moved, they're going to be 2 shots each.
Yep.
The
plus
leader
one
is
champ.
+1.
Mm-hmm.
And because I did all our attack, they're going to be hitting on 3s.
Right.
Because they've got poison, 5s are mortal wounds.
And 6s are
6s 3. 6s are mortal wounds +1.
Yep.
So let's see what we roll. Okay, so
2 6s. So that's 6 so
mortals
far.
There.
Plus.
And then we've got 3 5s
for fives.
Another 6 mortals. Go away, 1s and 2s. Oh.
Did it,
okay,
did
and
it,
then
did
these it. Are going to wound on something.
Threes.
Freeze, is
yep.
it?
Okay, so that's one at round.
Unless you lied last time. But no, I just remember it's threes. It's fours to hit, threes to wound.
Yes.
So, but it's minus one.
Minus one.
So it goes through.
So,
so it's just an
addition. Okay, so that's going to be six plus eight is 14 damage.
14.
So 14, holy five crap. Up saves.
That is intense, sir. Very rude, I might add.
Indeed.
How many was it again?
14.
14, okay.
We'll try to get rid of these squigs.
Yeah, I mean, I would too.
That's the plan.
Five ups. So, boop, boop. One, two, three, four and a half dead squigs.
Okay.
So you did nine wounds so far?
Nine wounds.
So you just need to do one mortal wound, or you just need to get like one more wound through with the rest of them. So, sorry, it was one, two, three, four and a half dead squigs. So we'll go one, two, three, four, and put a wound.
And then these guys moved sideways, because why not?
Yeah.
So they're also going to be doing hasty shots.
This all checks out.
Do not have poison, though, and...
Oh, yeah, because I killed that shaman, right?
Yes, because he killed my shaman.
Yeah, but you do three mortals on any sixes.
And then they do not have plus one to hit, so this is going to be hitting on fours.
No sixes.
Dear God. Wow. You'll still get some.
On threes.
Threes.
One.
Okay.
So two damage.
Two damage.
Maybe our entire army's plan shouldn't have been.
Yeah, you'll be fine. You got these guys.
Shouldn't have been to rely on sixes.
I did say one. But
okay,
that,
so
that
one squig dies.
Yeah, that doesn't mean that one guy dies. So you get your battle tactic.
Oh no, I'm not going to get my battle tactic because you're going to hit me back and kill me.
Well, but you get to attack first.
I'm not going to kill you, though. Enough damage there. So these guys are then going to attack.
Okay.
So I have no idea what Hobgrots do, because they just explode, usually.
I've never even used them.
Okay,
before.
So they get one ranged attack each.
I did
know they were 8-inch range, so
is
they are...
Is it threes and threes?
It's fours and threes.
Fours and threes, okay. Minus one.
Yeah, so...
Is it just one
so
damage?
So to them. Fours and threes, rend one damage.
Okay.
So here we go. Oh,
there you
look
go.
At my sixes and fives.
Yeah.
The freeze. So that's going to be four at rend one into your shot.
Four at rend one. So that will nullify the light of the bad moon. I'm going to all out defense them because I'm not going to get
the light
to...
of the bad moon?
Yeah, because... Wait a minute. Oh, Scrygrot's over there now.
Scrygrot moved backwards.
Oh, there you go.
So they're not.
I'm going to all out defense if that's okay.
Okay.
I don't have any, I can't use CDP over
fine.
Here.
Yeah.
I keep forgetting to.
Yeah, it's fine.
While filming, it's hard to remember. So they goes back to a four.
Yeah, almost save.
Cool. So they save two. Two go through.
And then
the after how much
save,
damage?
One damage each.
Okay, so fives. They save one. One
so
goes
one
through.
Damage.
And I'll get a dice and put it on this guy.
Okay, so then it's gonna be combat phase because I can't really charge.
Yeah.
Oh god, what have I done to myself? Okay, so I guess I'm gonna pile in an attack and hope for the best.
Yeah, I guess your hope is to do enough wounds
that
so
you
that
then don't do 10 back to me.
Yeah, you won't want me to stop me from doing a bunch of wounds back.
Yeah. Sorry for being so clumsy, people. Yeah. You guys should be able to just go up there. They got 2-inch reach each.
So yeah, no worries.
I'll just whack you back.
Yeah.
So that's going to be 21 attacks. Because I need it, let's spend the last CP to do all that attack.
Absolutely.
Ooh, baby. We need to get some impressive damage in so that we don't take 10 damage back.
Right.
Because otherwise we then fail the battle tactic.
Right.
So 21 attacks. This is hitting on threes.
Okay.
Sixes are going to be two more wounds.
Cool.
So hitting on threes.
There you go. That's a lot of sixes.
I'm looking for the fails, but oh yes it is. Why hello there, sixes.
Now there's six there.
Oh yeah.
So you've got 12
mortal
wounds so far.
And a lot of hits.
Yeah.
Can we convert these though?
That is the question.
we convert quite a lot of them. So I'll take that. So that's going to be 5 at no rend, so 6 up save.
And save 1.
Okay, so that's going to be 4 damage from them.
Plus 12.
And 12 damage from them, so 16 damage.
That's a lot of damage.
That is a lot of damage from these gut rippers.
Yeah.
10 gut rippers just being, did 16 damage.
They're being more impressive than the bolt boys, which are normally kind of the backbone.
Yeah, they're the best part of the whole army. Or are they?
Yeah.
Gut rippers are the new meta. You heard it here first.
Yeah, exactly. Said no one ever.
Oh.
5 ups. So we saved a decent amount of
please,
these.
Please stop saving them, Rob.
I choose not to take your advice.
Oh.
So we got 4.5 more squigs that are deet. 4. And I'll put 1 wound on
a guy who's going to be the first guy to battleship.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
Okay, so cool. Your turn to pile in an attack.
That's true. I'll be right back because I got to get my dice ready.
Yeah.
Okay, we got some squig on orc action coming up. I'm minus 1 to hit because of the scare shields, as Alex was kind enough to remind me. And then, let's see.
Battle round 1, so you're minus 1 to wound as well.
Minus 1 to wound, exactly. So we're hitting on 5s. The 6s are mortal wounds in addition.
Oh, that's a lot of mortal wounds.
That's a lot of mortal wounds.
I would rather you don't do that, Rob.
Yeah, I bet. Okay, so.
Gross.
But it's 5s to hit. So,
and there's a lot of 5s as well. Ooh, look at all those fives.
Okay, so I'm going to pull out the misses, right?
Oh my god.
That's a lot of fives.
He's rolled 5s and he's pulled out misses.
Okay.
That's how good the roll was.
That was so good. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave these here and just going to add 6 dice back in. So, because that way we can remember.
So then this is going to be 4s to wound.
So we got... That's pretty good.
And what's their rend right now?
2.
They're still on rend 2?
Because of the Gobblepalooza. So we've got...
I just failed my battle tactic.
2, 4, 6, 7 at minus 2.
Okay. Plus 6 mortal wounds.
Plus 6 mortal wounds. So that's going to be 13 damage. Yeah.
So I failed my battle tactic.
You did. I also failed my battle tactic.
I'm going to take 13.
Yay!
Okay, so...
Fail, brothers, Alex.
Yeah. So 13 damage is going to be...
6 dead guys plus 1 guy taking 1
6
wound.
And a half.
Yeah.
So I might as well roll battle shot now.
Do it.
I get a 3 plus the 6 guys, so that will be a failed battle shock, but I'm within an inch of this guy.
So they just...
So I lose 1 more, so I'm just going to remove 7 guys.
Cool.
I think then we have
now we got mine.
Battle shock.
Now, do I choose to nuke another guy?
That is the question.
5 plus 4 is 9 guys that I lost this turn. 9 minus 3 is 6, so it'll be 6 plus whatever I roll. That's too much fun, Alex. I'm not going to use my battle shock immune because...
It's 6 plus whatever you roll.
Yeah. Oh. So okay. Here we go. Do, 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 cha! 2.
Okay, so he's going to lose 8 guys.
8 guys. So I'm going to put the 6 into this guy.
Into the shaman?
Yeah.
No.
And then...
Do you have 6 guys within 9 of him? Yes, you do.
Yeah, sure do.
Yes, you do.
Okay.
Okay, so roll 6 first.
6. And...
One failed.
Okay.
So he takes 5 so far.
And he dies.
Okay, so... You've done 7 of your dice so far and killed my other shaman.
And then I've got 1 more dice, right?
Okay.
I'll do...
Yes, have 1 more dice. So who's going to take a mortal wound?
I'll shoot it into a crossbow guy. I'll shoot it into them. Yeah.
Into them?
Yeah.
Okay.
So...
Just a random spiteful mortal wound.
1 mortal wound. Yeah.
Just take it.
I'm a goblin, I'm full of spike.
Okay, well that was painful. I fail my battle tactic. I only hold 1 objective. It's not looking good for the crow boys, folks. So we're hoping to pull this back in later turns.
Right.
Guess we're going to clean up the table and then roll for priority. So we'll be right back for priority. Time for the battle shock roll. Will crow boys...
Battle shock.
Sorry, yes.
No worries.
The priority roll.
The priority roll!
Will Cruel Boys win the game? So what's Rob gonna roll first?
Hiya! Four!
It was a four, so I'm gonna roll a five up to take the turn.
Yep.
And win the game.
Yep, and win the game. Oh! Bam, 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 bam!
Cruel Boys take the turn.
Yep.
Yeah.
Are you you're taking it?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
I need to.
Okay.
Okay, we'll be back with Cruel Boys turn two.
Okay, before we go into the priority roll, I forgot to mention that I did roll for this, and I rolled a three, so it just stays where it is.
Okay.
But yeah, so now it's Cruel Boys, turn two!
Woo!
Yeah!
So I'm going to gain two command points, because my general's still on the table.
You are yes, that's true. Your general's alive.
Yeah.
As
for
is mine.
Now.
For now.
For now.
Yeah.
Okay, as it's round two, I'm no longer minus one to be wounded, so I need to start cleaning this table up fast.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, I've lost half my crew, my bolt boys, and somebody has popped both my shamans.
Yes.
well, that was painful.
Squigs are not OP. I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm not sure why they can kill something 9 inches away from a battle shot.
It really should just be three.
Yeah.
It should be three, but...
Or even six. Nine inches is absurd.
9 inches as far as these guys can throw a boulder. I guess they're fleeing is the idea. It's still dumb that you can direct it, but...
Anyway, so...
Yeah, for, yeah, go on. Yeah, so moving
for,
right along.
For battle tactics, we're going to do cunning maneuver.
Yeah.
This guy is going to be the guy who's going to do it because he has Tunnel Master.
Exactly.
So he can do it easily.
You point and click.
And then we're going to roll for a CP on my general. We get it.
Nice.
We're going to immediately spend it to
wait,
rally.
Wait, wait.
No. Okay.
Oh, wait, no. Is rally?
At the start. Like,
yeah, it's at the start, so yeah.
So I will immediately spend it to rally these
guys. I
didn't
know what you were going to say, but then I figured out what you were going to say.
So sixes. We got 1 6, and it's hidden under this building.
Nice.
So you can see I'm not cheating.
Nice.
Yet.
I just assume you cheat.
yeah, I am playing Crow Boy, so I do need to start cheating soon.
Excellent.
It's the rules. So we get one gut ripper back.
If any faction was going to cheat it, it's going to be Cruel Boys.
Yeah. So what's your heroic action going to be, Rob?
I'm going to try and roll a CP on the fungoid.
Okay.
Oh, yay. Oh, yes, we both finally got one.
Yeah. What's he going to spend it on this turn, though? That is the question.
Nothing.
Probably all-out defense.
Probably that. Maybe... Yeah, maybe.
So I have nothing to do in the hero phase because somebody killed my wizards. And my,
Who are you talking about?
And my guy who's guys who pass out poison. So I guess we're just going to be back in the movement phase.
Okay. Oh, wait, actually, sorry. I do want to try and unbind my Ravenix.
Oh, you're going to try to dispel your Ravenix?
Yeah.
Okay.
I already did that. So
dispel.
Seven.
Got to beat it.
Which is, and that's beating it, right?
It's I have no idea. I don't know.
Well, I'll look it up in between.
Yep.
We'll be back at the end of the movement phase.
Okay, so this is what it looks like after the movement phase.
Yep.
These guys ran forward and got just enough bodies on to steal it from these guys.
You did.
These guys ran backwards because they're cowards.
Uh-huh.
These guys sort of moved over here, Tunnel Master that way, and then I paid a CP for a 6-inch run so that he would get on.
Yep.
Because my grand plan... is to kill all these squigs so that it's just his hero left.
Mm-hmm.
And then I will have four bodies on versus his two.
Yes.
So.
And that will almost certainly work.
Hopefully.
I'm okay with that because then I at least get to do eye for an eye and stuff.
Yeah.
So.
So
and I might get the unit back anyway.
I would rather you don't get your unit.
Yeah.
Stop it. Okay, so.
I refuse.
Oh, are you Jaws of Mork?
No, I'm the Trog one.
Okay,
yeah.
I was going to say if you were Jaws and Mort, you had an extra attack, but if you're the Trog one,
that's
I
true.
Don't know what that does.
The Trog one makes it so that I heal after I fight with
Ooh,
Trogs.
Okay.
It's just fun.
Okay, it's going to help them a lot against these Hobgrats.
Yes.
Yes. Okay, so...
Hopefully they'll survive the Hobgrats on foot.
So the shooting phase, these guys are going to shoot first.
Cool.
I'm going to spend that last CP.
Okay.
Give myself all that attack.
Do it.
So they're going to be hitting on three.
Okay.
And they're shooting squids. Goodbye, squids. Okay, so we got two sixes. So they're going to be three mortal wounds each.
Yep.
And then, oh, that was a good roll for three ups.
You all attack them, right?
Yep. And then freeze to wound.
And ooh, another good roll. So we'll take that. So that's going to be six at round one. So that's going to be 12 damage from them.
Yeah,
and then six damage from them. 18 damage.
Okay.
Okay.
So 2, 4.
I'm sorry for everyone wearing headphones. 8, Rob just whistled.
10, 12, 14, 16.
Die, Squeak.
18.
Die.
Yeah, this is not going to go well. But I think my whistle's okay, but I do apologize. If it is loud, I'll just turn it down in post.
Nice.
But five up.
Hands. Oh my god.
Whoa. Holy crud. My god. That is good. So you can buy these dice at email sagaofdice@gmail.com. We got
1, 2, 3, 4
squigs are still
just
dead.
Four.
So it kills 3 squigs, actually.
Okay.
I'm just gonna actually you. Okay.
Ooh, actually.
Actually, it's and a herder.
Okay.
So
And then the other guys here shoot. So they're gonna be 9 shots. Hitting on 4s because they moved.
That's true. And they can't all attack because you already all attack.
And I've got no CP.
That's true. Oh, that part. There's that as well.
Ooh.
Oh, gee.
Two hits.
Luckily, the wounds just go through. So four damage.
So 4 damage.
And we got 5 up ward. Save 2 of them.
Oh my god.
What a jerk. Doink.
So if he uses his triumph to survive that, then I don't get the objective on my battle tactic again.
So we're going to go straight into the charge phase here, folks.
So you just need to charge.
I need to make this charge, and I don't have CP to do it with.
You do not.
Come on, big boy. Make your charge.
Big boy. He's wild and tough. He did not make
6
it.
6 inches. I don't think that is.
That is definitely outside of 6.
But it might not be.
No, it's like 7.5, dude.
Come on, viewers, agree with me. That's totally
it's like
in.
7.5.
Oh, my God. So the Gut Rippers are going to charge.
Okay. They have an even further charge,
I think. But the plus one's a charge.
That's not going to help.
Oh, my God.
This guy?
Oh, I forgot to shoot with these. I'll shoot.
Oh, yeah, you'll shoot with them.
That guy ran, so he can't charge.
Oh, dear. He can.
That guy's outside a 9, or he was supposed to be outside a 9, so we'll see.
Yeah, so he needs a 9.
That's oh my god!
What the hell?
So we'll just roll shooting for these guys.
Oh dear.
We will try not to be depressed about what just happened.
Right.
Depression, here it comes.
And these guys are no longer need to worry about coherency because they are only 4 of them.
So all 8 attacks are actually going to go into that unit.
This one's already taken a wound.
Yeah, but I'll just move them out of range back.
Oh, okay.
Force.
I'm using Rob's blasted scaven dice.
Yeah. The great. You know what happened?
3 at rend 1 into them.
3 at rend 1. They are not in the light of the bad moon. I'm sorry. I meant to all out defense them because I'm just swimming
in
command
range. Rides.
No, you are not because it's wholly within 12.
Okay.
Wholly within 12.
That's cool. So 3 you said?
3 at rend 1.
They save all of them. Oh, no, they miss one.
They miss one. So and 1 damage.
Oh,
how do you save?
You know why, though? I told you I should play Skaven. Do you remember this conversation, Alex? I said, let me play Skaven. And what did you say?
No, I want to play against Goblin.
I believe what you said was bring
this.
Your best army. Yeah.
I chose this.
Yeah,
folks.
Yeah. He brought this on himself.
Boy.
I argued against it, for the record.
Yeah. So are you going to battle shock them, or are you going to use your triumph?
Let me think. No, I'm not going to battle shock them. I'm going to use my once a game triumph to deny your battle tactic.
Oh, okay.
So you will get 1, and you
two.
Will get 2.
So I'm going to get 2 VP.
You will.
So that will take me up to 3 victory
3
points.
Victory points.
Versus Rob's 5
and
from having a
God have mercy on your soul. We'll see. Maybe I'll just zap myself a bunch of times in the crotch.
I at this point, need him to kill himself. So
if anyone can kill themselves... It's a Skaven player. Alex, I think you have an army that's really good.
I do. What? I have Karatron Overlords.
Yes.
We have never seen them on the channel because I refuse to play them.
Well, we've seen them on the channel, but you've never brought them on the channel.
That's true.
Yes.
Sorry.
Yes.
You've never seen me play them on the channel because I refuse to play them.
That was a huge insult to Andy, and that's what I appreciate about you,
Andy,
Alex.
Andy doesn't exist to me because he's a dirty southerner.
That's true. That's all true. English politics, everyone.
Yeah.
We'll be back.
We'll be
back with Cruel Boys. I mean, Cruel Boys. We'll be back with
Yes. Cruel Boys. Ted Free.
Darn it! Now I have to do it. We're back for Gloomspite Gits, turn two, for my battle tactic that I've decided to do: stab him in the dark. My heroic action. I'm going to try and roll for a CP on Skaggy, also known as Scragrot. He doesn't get it again. Alex, what are you going to do for your heroic action? Wait, what are you doing, Alex?
I'm researching my next army, Rob.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Pro Boys is not going well.
What are we?
So, yeah. Gloomspite Gits aren't broken. I don't know what everyone's talking about. Anyway, heroic action, Alex. What are you going to do?
Let's take an Unbind.
An Unbind, okay, yes. Cool. So first up is going to be... these guys here, they're going to try and do Fungoid Cloud again for -1 to hit. That will not go off. Once again, they are absolute utter failures. I'm going to use different dice. So then they're going to try and do Mystic Shield onto... Oh, and I just pulled off they can't roll less than a 1, so I just pulled that wound off. They're going to try and put a Mystic Shield on these fellas here. That's an 8.
Let's try Unbind. Who is it?
These guys here. Yeah. You're more than in range.
Let's see if I can roll a 9 plus.
Whoa!
Oh,
dang it!
Yeah! Where were you when I was rolling my charges?
Yeah, for real. Okay.
Any of my charges.
Oh my god.
Please give me this one.
Hopefully not. Now I guess it's going to be... The Fungoid is going to try and roll Hand of Gork.
I'd rather he didn't.
That will go off with a... Oh, that's
a 6.
That is a 6. It's got like a little dot on it. So I'm going to use a different dice from now on. So that is a 6.
Does that go off?
I don't think so.
I think it's a 7, right?
I think it's a 7, so...
In fact, I have the Gloomspite Gits book right
here. Yeah, you do, yeah.
So I can look it up while you continue.
I'll think about my options here. These guys are going to hand out an extra pip of rend to them with Nasty Poison, and Skaggy is going to do...
It goes off on a 7.
It goes off on a 7, okay. So then that means Scragrot is not going to...
Aha, he can't see me.
Well, I'm going to do Ravenix again.
Oh.
Yeah. +1. So it goes off, but it's actually a 7. So.
Okay. So you're going to put it wholly with an 8?
Yep. I guess maybe I'll do that, and then I'll also check the other spell I want to try and do. Okay, and then I've also got to roll 4 dice for these guys. So yeah, there's no other spell that he can do. So I put it down, and then these guys roll 4 dice. Four ones, and then they're all dead.
That was not 4 ones. I was hoping for 4 ones.
That is the opposite of 4 ones. That was 0 ones. So 43 guys come back, or squeaks come back. Well, there you go.
You heard it, folks. 43 guys.
43. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Only 4 squeaks come back.
Because this is our dodgy dice.
Yep.
Shows.
It looks like it, but luckily I didn't mix it up. So we got 4 guys coming back.
I'd rather they didn't.
I'd rather they did, actually.
Do not like.
There has to be outside of 3. No, they don't have to be outside of 3. But.
Do not like.
And then at the end here, I'll roll this to see if anything cool happens.
Oh, and for our eagle-eyed viewers who noticed before, I did Cunning Maneuver.
Yeah.
And then went to go over here.
Right. We didn't explain that.
And it wasn't even possible to do.
Unless you killed that guy.
Unless I killed that guy.
And those guys were in sharpshooters, to be fair.
Yeah, they were, but I had moved them so they couldn't shoot it in because they weren't in range.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
So that was a poor battle tactic choice by me.
And then that you failed anyway.
So clearly,
insult to injury.
Clearly, it's not Cruel Boys. It's me.
Oh, I don't know about that. It's still Cruel Boys, in my opinion.
No, it's me.
I mean, I did play them last time against your ogres. So maybe it's you and me.
Yeah.
I'll settle for that. Okay, and then last and least is Ravenix. He's going to move. There we go. 9, 10 inches. It's not going to get him into anything.
10 inches, or do you want to re-roll that?
Oh!
Because you just summoned it, so you could fish for
I actually 18. Am going to roll... yeah, because, like, if it's not going to get in range probably anyway, so that's worse.
Ha-ha! Tricked him into
you lured me again!
Worse.
I mean, it's like, what? Plus 3 inches?
Yeah.
It wasn't going to hit no matter what, so...
It wasn't going to hit.
No. Okay, so that means that I am going to go into my movement phase, and we'll be right back. Okay, it is the shooting phase, but first I'm just going to explain. So I got my squigs back here. These guys auto ran, just get them kind of moving in this general direction. And then Ravenix ended here. Did I roll that on camera?
Yeah, I think you did.
Okay.
Just think you didn't move it.
I didn't move it. Yeah, that makes sense. And then these guys moved up here, and I was going to throw some boulders at them, but then I might not make my charges. And if I make my charge with one of those units, they are getting wiped off the face of this earth.
No, they're not. They're going to live.
Yeah, exactly. So,
Cruel Boys.
So I need to make one of these 5-inch charges, right?
Okay, so who's going to charge first?
Team
Blue or Team
Blue.
Team Green?
Team Blue.
Team Blue.
Yeah.
5-inch charge.
They make it.
5 inches.
5 inches. Ugh. So
Team Green?
Put that next to them. And then Team Green will also try and charge. They do not make it, but I'm going to reroll that.
Oh my god, why do you have so many CP?
Goblins. Oh, I forgot to mention, actually, I did tell Alex at the start of my turn, I'm taking my once per game Warlord.
Yep.
Did I roll my 4 up on my Goblin? I think I tried it, but I failed it, but... And they fail. That's okay. So I'll move them in, I'll get my attacks ready, and then I'll be right back. Okay, we're in for the combat phase. I'm going to spend a CP immediately for my general to give all-out attack. And when he gives all-out attack, he gives an extra attack, Alex, which means I've got 18 attacks. Hitting on 2s, wounding on 3s, they are -3 red from Gobapalooza, and they're an additional -1 rend from the Moonface Moppet for four rend against
Hobgrots.
Against Hobgrots, who have a 6-up save.
Guys, I'm glad there is no power creep in this game.
Yeah, what are you talking about, power creep? What does this mean? I don't know what you're talking about.
So let's roll your attacks.
Everything's
see
fine, Alex.
Hobgrots live.
Let's see if I get 17 ones.
Yep.
Okay, 18 attacks, hitting on 2s. I got 3 ones. I think it's over for me.
Okay.
Wounding on 3s.
3s?
Yes.
So 1s and 2s on the Hobgrots are going to live.
Yeah. And they're not in the light of the Bad Moon, which they can't be.
For. That's a lot of 1s and 2s.
That's a lot of 1s and 2s.
But I'm dead everywhere.
Yeah. Big time. We got, it's just a measly 18 damage. That's actually not that good considering.
That was actually quite a bad roll.
Yeah. True to
but
form.
It's still more than enough to kill 10 Hobgrots.
As it turns out.
So that's Rob holding 1 objective.
Yep.
2 objectives.
More objectives.
And he killed a unit that wasn't in the light of the Bad Moon.
Yep.
So he gets his battle tactic.
For 5 points.
For 5 more points. That
taking
takes
me
Rob
to 8.
10, isn't it?
No, because I got 3 because I failed my battle tactic.
Oh,
the first
turn
because he missed the charge.
Yes.
Yeah.
So it's 8-3.
8-3.
Going into priority.
And no one has any battle shock to do. Hey-o!
I got a
4.
Rob's got a 4. Are you going to take the turn, Rob?
I am going to take the turn.
Oh, my God.
Oh, and before...
Oh, my God.
I was supposed
oh
to do
God.
This beforehand.
Oh, my God.
But I'm not going to roll it. For Scragrot's going to make the moon go into the middle of the table, so it's
so
covering
it go to the, middle,
the
so
entire
the board.
Yeah.
Oh no.
So I'm about to auto get another battle tactic.
Is this the end for Cruel Boys? Find out in the next episode.
Next couple of minutes.
Oh no. Oh,
we'll be back.
Don't jump to the next episode.
Okay. It's Gloomspike Git's turn 3.
Oh no.
We're back. And I'm going to do two battle tactics, because that's what I can do for this.
Because this guy is on the objective.
He is. So I'm going to do Follow the Moon.
Yeah.
Which
is auto-complete.
I've got it. Yeah, I've basically got it, as long as I don't lose everything. And then I'm going to do Desecrate Their Lands, and just because why not? Like, this is just kind of fun. I'm going to try and teleport a unit into the back there, capture the objective.
There should be a third thing here, but I'm clumsy and I broke it. I'm sorry, Rob.
It's okay. I think I fixed it. So that's that. Heroic action, I'm going to try and roll a CP on my general.
He's just flexing on me for more CP, folks.
Yeah, I'm trying. I don't get it again.
I'm going to take an unbind on my guy so that I can try and remove Rob's teleport.
That's true.
So that he can't get this desecrate.
I like it. Not really. So then I'm going to do... Oh, yes. So the squigs, before I forget, I've got four squig herders.
Four ones.
Nope.
No ones.
No. Once again.
Please stop.
Should I stop?
No.
Okay. Then I won't.
Oh my god.
2, 4, 6 + 3 is 9 more squigs.
The whole unit's coming back.
1, 2, 3, 4.
The only thing saving me right now is they have to be within an inch of the model that's already on the table.
9. But
there's so much space.
There's so much space. I just wrap them around there.
Yeah, you just wrap them around your unit.
I
actually really appreciate that because I think I forgot.
My mission this game, guys, is to kill a single unit.
That makes sense. This unit here?
I've lowered my crowbar standards.
I hope it's this unit. Yeah.
I've lowered my standards as crowbars.
Yeah.
I'm hoping to kill a single Gloomstrike Gitz unit.
That makes sense. That checks out to me.
Okay.
So then... Well, then before I forget, I'm going to put the 6 up mortal wounds from this guy here.
Yep.
I am going to not move these guys when that happens. And then now some spell casting. Let's do a Mystic Shield on these guys here.
Okay.
That will go off with a 9.
You can have it.
Cool.
I'm saving it for that teleport.
I know. But I wanted to try.
Okay.
You know? I wanted to tempt you.
You could teleport Scragrop to like here.
Yes.
So you do desecrate, and then on his second spell he can shoot my girl by
He can just do his mortal wound thing, hey?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's the plan actually. So then I'll just do that next.
Teleport?
Yeah.
On a 10,
that's
plus
11.
One, 11.
Plus 1. So you need a
I'm just
gonna
roll box cards right now, casually.
Oh, okay. Casually. You casually failed.
Guys, this is boxcars, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
That's true.
Look.
Yep.
Look, Rob.
Yep.
It was 2 6s.
Yeah, I didn't see anything.
Yeah, it's 2 6s, folks.
Okay.
Does everyone agree?
You
just need to teleport.
I think we can all agree on that. So then he goes there, I think.
Okay. And
then he's inside of 12. He's inside of 12.
Okay.
So he can officially see them.
Yes, he can see things now.
Yay!
So what's he going to cast his second spell?
He's
going to
do his custom spell.
Yep.
His War Scroll spell.
His War Scroll spell.
I think I get more mileage out of them.
Maybe roll it, then choose.
No, I know. But I'm just... Oh, actually, I see what you're saying. I see what you're saying. I don't have to roll first. That's true.
Yeah.
Plus 1 is 10. Do you have an unbind?
No.
Okay. So I'll just roll it.
Is it 10? Is it the modified roll or the unmodified?
Yeah.
Oh my god, it's the modified roll. Oh my god. Who are you going to choose? Which unit?
I think it makes sense to go into them, doesn't it?
Into the big unit or the little unit?
I think if you go into the little unit, you might kill the whole unit. But if you go into the big unit, you might battle shock the unit.
Yeah. I'll do that.
Which unit are we going to pick?
I think I get more mileage out of shooting into them.
Okay.
Especially because I want to charge. In
okay.
So 3s are mortals.
Oh my god.
So that many mortals.
Rob,
so 9 mortals.
Oh my god.
Wait, I didn't roll enough dice, did I?
No, that's not enough mortals. That's not enough dice, Rob.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'm cheating against myself. So 7, so I need 3 more dice.
Okay.
Yeah, it's still 9.
And my guy who makes me immune to spells is over here.
Yeah. Yeah. Hi.
I chose Polly.
Hi, buddy.
Okay, so these guys are going to take 9 mortals.
Yeah.
So they have 2 wounds each.
So 4 guys die.
Two guys, I think.
Yep.
Pretty sure that's two guys. Oh no. Oh no.
And then, and one guy takes one wound.
Yep.
Cool. And then.
And then, any more spells?
I'm gonna try and do Fungoid Cloud on these guys, see if they can cast a spell in this game. It's nope.
Nope.
Still no.
Okay.
Okay then, and then they can't do anything else because they're not, they can't see anything.
Okay, and so, then this thing moves.
And then this thing moves.
3d6.
Oh, and then this guy, these guys do the thing at the start of the movement phase, so I'll just do that on camera now. Two up, they have a 5-up ward, and on a 5-up, they have an extra attack. Two up, so they just have the 5-up ward.
Okay, so just, this thing is gonna move.
Yep, 3d6.
Awesome.
That, that's a good roll.
12.
I'm not going to. You can't make me re-roll this one, okay?
You can't re-roll it anyway.
Your tricks don't work on me.
12. So you can either ram it into this guy and do like four mortals, or you could ram it into these gut rippers and just give the gut rippers.
Let's do that.
I think. 12 minus 5 is 7 damage. No, there will be one alive and one wound.
Wait, this guy's movement's pretty bad, right?
It's 8.
8.
So you do. So
4?
4.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll just murk them.
Just kill some more of my units.
Yeah.
Okay, on a 2-up.
2-up.
Do I lose 3 guys?
Hi-yo! Yep. That's a 6. Okay. So, you take?
I take 7 moles.
7, right. So you lose 3 guys and take and 1 take extra wound. Cool.
It's not going well for the crew, boys.
That's true.
I was advised against bringing this army.
Yes. I literally was like, no. Everyone, literally everyone told him not to bring this army. Alex does not take directions well.
I have to suffer, to believe.
That's true. Yeah,
and
true.
Even then,
traditionally,
I still end up taking the army to a tournament.
And he also refuses to take a good army.
That's true.
This is also on him.
That's true. After this, guys, it's probably Iron Jaws.
Yes, yeah.
Which, if we look at the stats, is fine.
Yeah.
Totally fine.
You should play Fire Slayers.
No.
No? Are they good?
I could...
You notice how that's my question?
I could play 6 Magma Drops, which is abjectly terrible right now.
Oh, okay.
The actual Fire Slayers are okay now.
Maybe in the new GHB. I think that's everything for me. Oh, and I'm going to hand an extra pip of Rend to these guys.
Okay, extra Rend for these guys.
Extra Rend, and then we'll be back in just a moment. It is the charge, or actually first it's the shooting phase. Just kind of moved everyone up. These guys didn't run. Alex redeployed. What did you redeploy, Alex?
An inch.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it wasn't very good.
No, it wasn't, as it turns out. So yeah. Then...
it's not looking good for this guy over here.
No, it's not looking as good, is it? It's looking less good.
Crow boys have got this, guys.
We'll see. I don't know.
Heroic recovery.
I don't know.
In game 2.
Yeah. So these guys are going to throw their boulders into them.
Okay.
They're doing 1 mortal wound on 3s. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4 mortal wounds.
Oh.
On these guys.
How many?
4.
4.
Yeah.
Oh, let's pull a guy at the front. Oh, let's make it a 6-inch charge for
I don't
front.
I think it's still
I think it's probably still a 5-inch
It might
charge.
Be a 5, but we'll see.
It might be a 6-inch charge.
Speaking
now.
Of which, here he goes nothing. That's an 8.
That's an 8.
That'll get them
he
in.
He definitely makes it.
And then I'm going to charge these guys in as well. Miss Squiggles.
Okay.
That will make it.
No, they don't make it. I don't believe it.
Yeah. So I'm just going to move them in, and then we'll be right back.
Okay, so after Rob's made his charges, we're going to unleash hell with these two guys.
This is true.
So that's going to be 5 shots.
Yep.
Ooh, 2 6s.
Whoa, that's pretty
beautiful.
Good.
And then 2 hits. So then wounding on 3s.
Okay.
2 at Rend 1 against your Mystic Shield. So.
And in the Light of the Bad Moon. So plus 2, minus 2. Or plus 2, minus 1. So they're still, they're saving on 3s. And they save them both.
And then 6 mortal wounds.
6 mortal wounds.
Would you like some of my dice?
No. Light of the Bad Moon, blue, once in a blue moon dice. Saving on 5s. Only save 1. Maybe I should have taken it. It actually kills a troll.
Yeah.
Puts a wound on another one.
Yeah.
That's crazy. Okay, I'll pull this guy.
Okay, and then because he's made a charge into them,
yeah.
He has the breath of the Maia Drakes from his banner.
Yep.
This is gonna do something at the start of combat. I rolled a 4, so it's gonna do 1 mortal wound.
Which they do not save, so they take a wound.
Yeah, take that mortal wound.
Blink! Right
there. Oh, yeah.
Okay,
so these guys are gonna pile
them. I'm gonna go first, yeah. You can just pile them in slightly.
Are you gonna issue all that attack?
I am.
Okay.
But I want to be.
That gives them 1 extra attack, I hear.
It does. So they're just gonna pile in like that, slightly. Okay. They're still in range.
Yep.
So then they get 3 times 5.
Okay.
Is 15, and they don't get any kind of extra.
Yep.
Like, there's no champion.
Kind of. And they're +1 to hit, but they're -1 to hit because they're targeting.
Cool. Gut rippers. So 3s and 3s.
Okay.
Boop. So 2, and they got the trick 2 in there again. There we go. Wait, why did I pull out the 2s?
Because you -1 to hit.
Oh, right. You just said that, right. Like, okay, wounding on 3s.
Oh.
So we got.
It's still plenty.
Yeah. So they're -4 rend.
Okay.
just -4. So I'm assuming that goes through?
Yeah.
So that is a paltry 24 wounds?
24 wounds?
Wait, 1 second. So that's 9
oh
times.
My God.
Wait, 9 times 3 is 27.
9 times 3 is indeed 27.
So only 27 wounds, Alex.
27 wounds.
Yes.
So I'm pretty sure that is the exact wound characteristic of a single gut ripper.
Yep, that's true. That checks out. So you're just going to take 1 guy off there.
Yeah, just 1 guy.
And it's not 13 and a half.
It might be.
I think it is.
I'd rather it isn't.
Yeah. Holy moly.
Oh my God.
Man, imagine if you hadn't gotten to unleash hell there.
yeah, that would have just been the squad. So I guess I go over there to fight back.
I guess so.
With this guy.
Yeah,
this guy. What a legend.
Yeah.
Okay, he's going to hit you back with his Merc Knob Cleaver.
Gross.
3 attacks on 3s. So 2 hits.
Yeah.
But 1 was a 6. So that's just mortal wounds.
Oh, right.
And then 3s to wound. 1 at rend 1, so it just
that goes through. Yeah.
So that's just going to be 4 damage.
4 damage, okay. So we got 5s. Saves 2 of them. So that kills 1.
A single
and the wound transfers over. Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, big spender. Dies. And then he dies horribly.
Like, I'm going to save Rob some time.
Fair enough.
Let him push that model off.
Okay.
And then I'm going to use the often not used whatever it's called, GHB command thing, to not pile in and just get a +1 attack.
Oh, cool.
Characteristic.
That's a good idea.
Because I have so few guys, I might as well just throw some attacks at him.
Are they in range of this guy's ability? Is it 12 inches?
I don't know. I could have probably pulled models smarter if it wasn't.
I think they're fine.
They're fine. Fine.
Cool.
So they're going to have 3 attacks each.
Nice.
We've got 6 guys.
6 guys.
So 6 times 3 is 18.
It's true.
+1.
It's still 18. Champion. 3 times 6 is still 18.
Still for now.
Yeah.
Maybe we should ask ChatGPT.
That's true.
Because I hear people are convincing it that 2+2 does not equal 4.
I did hear that, yeah. That's pretty funny. What legends.
Okay. So we're going to have 19 attacks. Nice. Hitting on 4s.
Cool. Okay.
Hitting 6 on 4s. 6 of mortals.
So we got 4 Ooh, 6s in there?
4 6s. So that's
2 each.
8 mortal wounds.
Nice.
And then we're hitting on 4s. Oh cool. My God. Where is it? Damn it. Sadness.
Epic sadness.
4s. 3 at no runs. So,
okay. So they're saving on 3s. So let's say they one take
damage.
1.
So 9 damage total.
9 damage. Whew. Goodness. Okay, so that's 5 + 4 = 9. Here we go. The whole unit's wiped. Not really. But they killed another one.
I also just forgot. I just spent my last CP, which means I'm going to fail this power shot horribly.
Oh, no. Oh dear. Oh, God. Hello, darkness, my old friend. That's the theme song of this. So they kill another one. And
this is a player playing very poorly.
I'm sorry, viewers. I am playing like trash.
But, Alex, to be fair, you're playing Cruel Boy, so it didn't really matter at the end of the day.
I mean, yeah. Some may say this list could have performed better.
Correct me if I'm wrong, Alex, but so one guy has taken two wounds, right?
Yeah.
Now, because it's my turn, I get to choose the order of operations, right?
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Wait, oh no, it's after they fight. Never mind. So one guy's taken two wounds. I was, because they get to heal after they fight.
Oh, yeah. It's after you fight, though, not after.
It's after you fight, but then I was thinking of something else where something did mortal wounds to me when it died. Oh, okay. And then I was like, someone was saying I could choose the order of fight.
Oh, okay.
It was against Korn. Murder rolls.
Okay, so battle shocks for me.
Battle shocks for you.
These guys lost three guys. Three plus four is seven, so that guy's gone.
Okay.
These guys lost...
Four?
Four guys?
I think so.
Yeah, because he killed them.
Right.
Five.
Yeah.
Plus four is nine.
Yeah.
So we'll just remove that unit. God. These guys lost 13 and a half guys.
13 and a half.
The half matters.
Oh, God.
So that's going to be a 16 versus bravery. So we'll just remove these from the table.
I've got this, guys.
Is it rude if I spend a CP to make these guys auto-pass?
Do it.
Because I'm going to do it, yeah.
Oh, my God.
So Cruel Boys, in it to win it with...
literally every...
Everything dead.
Yeah, and I got two battle...
I've not even... Yeah, Rob gets two battle tactics.
Battle tactics for four.
And holds on two more plus... for another three. So he gets seven total for this turn.
Oh, dear.
So he's got 15 now.
Yeah.
I'm still on three.
You're on four?
Three total.
Three?
Yeah.
You only get two the four? Oh, you don't
get
two.
One.
The
first one.
I didn't do that. I didn't do that on purpose, I swear to God.
I am gonna concede.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, folks. I don't feel like I can pull this one back. Oh my God.
Well, thanks for coming on, Alex. Alex has to travel very far, or else he would be on the channel more often, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Also, I would play out the rest of the game if I didn't have to travel.
So to all the Cruel Boys players, I just want to say...
I'm sorry.
No. I can turn this around for you, Alex, okay? I can turn it around. Everyone, say thank you to Alex, because... And send this video care of... Games Workshop at GWPC or whatever the heck their address is. Send them this video and just be like, yo, come on. I play Cruel Boys too. I like Cruel Boys. I want to take my Cruel Boys. So, come on, GW. It's time for a change, okay?
Okay.
But thanks again, Alex, for coming out.
Yep.
And we'll see you all next time.
Thanks.